Hello friends, welcome back. So in this step we are going to implement the Spring Cloud Bus. So in the last step we saw like whenever you are making a changes in the Git repository, we need to commit the changes, and thereafter you need to go to hit the multiple instances, okay, to refresh the configuration, okay. So here we'll implement the Spring Cloud Bus. So by implementing this, we'll not required to individually hit the instances. We'll be hitting the only one URL, and it will replicate, the change will be replicated to across all the microservices. So to implement the Spring Cloud Bus, okay, we have a multiple options like Apache Kafka or RabbitMQ. So since we have already implemented the RabbitMQ, okay, so we will be using the RabbitMQ here. If you go to the Spring website or official website, they have given the definition. This is the distributed system of a lightweight message broker, and this can be used using the either the Kafka broker or AMQP. AMQP is for the RabbitMQ. So you can use either the RabbitMQ or the Kafka. Okay, so we will be using the RabbitMQ here. Okay, so if you see here, we have already installed the RabbitMQ in the previous step, and our RabbitMQ is up and running in the services. If you go to the services, you will find here RabbitMQ is up and running, right? So to implement this, we will have to add the dependency, okay, in both limit service and Spring Cloud config server file. So let's add the dependency. So what will you do? You just need to copy quickly, paste here, and instead of starter config, we need to add the bus -AMQP and save it. That's it for the Spring Cloud Bus. Copy same thing. Okay, go to the Spring Cloud server and add here. Okay, add anywhere, control V, right? So this is the one thing. Okay, and we have in the last step, we had already for the security related on the actuator side, we had disabled the security on the limit service of configuration. So same thing we need to do for the bootstrap.properties of limit service. Okay, paste here and that's it. Okay, and let's quickly start the services of Spring Cloud service configuration and the limit service. So let me maximize this. Yeah, and if you see here currently in the, we have configured in a bootstrap prod profile. So it will go to the profile properties and it will retrieve this minimum and the maximum value. Yeah, so it is started. Let me also start the limit service, both the limit service instance and 8081. So it will take some couple of seconds to get it started. Okay, and thereafter started, we'll see how it's getting reflected. So now go here, you refresh this. It has already, okay. Not started. Yeah, I started now. For both 8080 instance, it's returning minimum and maximum, and here also it's returning minimum and the maximum, right? So now what we need to do, let's make a changes here. Let's say 4 is the minimum and 4444 is the maximum. I'm just saving it. I'm not committing this, even though I have made the change in the configuration file on the Git repository. Okay, I'm not going to commit. Okay, like in the last step, we used to commit from Git repository, right? Like this. So I'm not going to commit here. I just saved it. Okay, and thereafter, what I need to do, I need to refresh. So earlier we used to refresh of each and every instances, but using the Spring Cloud Bus, if you go to the official site, okay, so they have given the endpoint of actuator/bus refresh. By using this, this will be refreshed. Okay, and it will circulate to all the microservices. So by using this, we need to just invoke only one URL, not individually on all the instances. then go there, go to the postman and actuator bus refresh just need to do on in either of the port. So I will be doing the 8080 port on the post. It's send the request, it's sending the request. If you will sync 204 response, means the server successfully processed the request but it's not returning any content, that is fine. If you go there, okay, and if you see, refresh this, here it's got also reflected and here also got reflected. So we do not require to go each and every instances where your limit service is running. So only one, we invoked only one. So like if you have 100 services, you need to invoke only one. Okay, and you have also noticed we did not make any commit changes in the Git repository, right? So this is a two benefit. So like we don't require to manually do the commit, okay, and we don't require to manually go each and every instances to refresh the URL, okay. So all this is happening because of the Spring Cloud Bus, okay. So how it is internally working, okay. So Spring Cloud Bus basically is running on top of the RabbitMQ. I had shown you here RabbitMQ is already running. So it's running on top of the RabbitMQ. So whenever we are starting the application or microservices, okay, suppose you have 100 microservices. So whenever you are executing the microservices, it get registered with Spring Cloud Bus. Okay, so Spring Cloud Bus have all the required information. So whenever you will be making the changes in a configuration file, okay, the changes are called on any of the instances, the microservices will be sending an event over the Spring Cloud Bus. And that Spring Cloud, since Spring Cloud have all the microservice registered, it will send an event to all the microservices instances that has got registered with Spring Cloud. So all these things we are achieving through the Spring Cloud. But if you want to know more details about the Spring Cloud Bus, how it has got internally implemented, then you can go through this site basically, Spring IO site. So they have mentioned like how this is getting started, how they have internally implemented using the broker and all, and how the endpoint is getting used here. Okay, so all these things you can get it from here. Got it? So only what is the benefit? Okay, you don't need to hit the multiple instances, you need to hit only one instances, okay, for this endpoint, and it will be reflecting to all, okay, and it will be committing internally. You don't need to manually commit the changes, okay, and you need to just you need to follow only two steps. First is to add the dependency, AMQP dependency, in the pom.xml file, and another is to disable the security in a bootstrap.property file of limit services. And that's it. And all these things will be taken care of by the Spring only. Okay, so this is all about the Spring Cloud Bus. Okay, if you have a time, see you in the next step. Bye bye.